Okay, so this is the prologue right here, okay? So this book is the first 60 years of the Apostolic Assembly. If you don't see your church in these next chapters, don't start freaking out. You know, oh man, this is not accurate. You know, it's only to 1966, okay? So don't go there, okay? So don't get hurt, okay? That you're not in the book, that... Okay, we're going to move on. So we're going to go over the prologue. And the prologue gives you kind of the emotional part of this book. This is the editor kind of writing his emotions to you after him investigating all these people, okay? And that's what the prologue is all about. And it says like this, our history is the epitome of wonderful events, of miracles, of prowess, of abnegation, in its history of countless sacrifices, of passive yet heroic perseverance, of poverty, of hardship, of tears and limitations, of dreams fulfilled, of prophetic revelations, prosecutions, of slander and abuse, of glory, triumphs, and spiritual exaltations. So right here, as I'm reading these words off this prologue, I'm already hurting because, man, the primitive church, our primitive church, suffered, okay, for a to be set up like we are, to have district youth services, to have district camps. People suffered. They went through a lot of oppression. Being Mexican American in a fully American state, it's kind of hard, okay? And so they went through a lot of persecution in this book, and we get to see all of it in the next chapters to come. This is what I love about this textbook. There's another little excerpt here, and it says, if men could write it, it would fill thousands over thousands of pages, yet it would not be perfect. There is a tendency in men towards partiality. And so what that means is that they couldn't write everything that God did for the church, for the Apostolic Assembly in California in these first 60 years, okay? It couldn't be written down. And what I love is that kind of mirrors what the Bible says right there about Jesus and how he performed many miracles. He couldn't write everything that Jesus did. He was just healing people left and right, changing lives. And the same thing is happening in California. That made me so grateful for our assembly, okay? It made it super personal for me that it could even fill another textbook. They could fill textbooks and textbooks and textbooks worth of what Jesus has done in our lives. So as we go through the prologue, the editor wants you to learn something. He wants to give you a new sense, and it's called historical sense. There's an excerpt that reads like this. Historical sense has opened a new door, a new organ of perception in our bodies, the most human of all, for we can now perceive the past through it. Not merely as a historical past, but as a past of thrilling memoirs left by human lives. So what the editor is trying to get us to realize is to have this sense, this historical sense in our lives, to make it a part of us. There's a great scripture in the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 32 and on. It says, but remember the former days, okay? Remember the former days when after being enlightened, you endured great conflict of sufferings, partly by making made a public spectacle through reproaches and tribulations, and partly by becoming sharers with those who you were so treated, for you showed sympathy to the prisoners, and you accepted joyfully the seizure of your property, knowing that you have yourselves a better possession and a lasting one. So the Bible clearly says right here that sometimes we got to remember the past, okay? Remember where we used to be. So this is what the editor is saying, to remember our past. Don't stay there, but remember the past, that we were not always this great church that we are today, okay? Not the one that starts all these organizations, these conventions, these camps and stuff like that. We came from very poor people. We came from poverty, honestly. We came from immigrants, and we came from people that were just hungry for the touch of God, for the Holy Spirit to be placed in our lives. And so this is a great sense that we should have in our life. This called historical sense, to know where you came from. And I believe that's something that we should all learn and appreciate. And as we come to more of a close, this is something I want to remind each and every single one of you, although these people were humble, okay, most of them were farmers, people that didn't make much money, they started such an awesome move of God that got people saved. A majority of you have been born and raised in church. And because of these great men, your families were saved. Lifestyles were changed. People's lives were flipped around. People were stuck in a cycle. And that's what the enemy likes to have you in, is this cycle. Kind of something that happens over and over, these generational curses, okay, that the devil just has people in, families in. And because of this great movement here in California, lives were changed. And this is what I want to convey to you guys. And I love this little excerpt that says right here, it says, "The desire and purpose that inspired us to write this humble labor, the history of the Apostolic Church in the United States of America, has been primarily to thank and honor God for choosing a group of men," and I love this, and I highlighted this, it says, "despite the fact of being sinners, we're called according to his purpose and will to be saved in Christ and sanctified in the virtue of his name and precious blood, and to deposit in otherwise feeble hands." I love that. Feeble. Weak. Meek. Oh, I love that. And it says, "the duty to do his bidding in favor of the wrongdoers, making us associates." Associates, man. We're helping God. Associates in his plan of salvation, as it is if through us he were begging men to reconcile with him. This is what I want to convey to you guys, is the people that founded this church, they were sinners as well. They felt like they were insignificant sometimes. And what I want to convey to you guys, what I want to educate you guys on, is the fact that normal people can do great things when they get closer to God. And in these moments right now, these kind of scary moments that we're having, this is an opportunity to get closer to God. And if it wasn't for people that started praying in 1906 for a great movement of God in the state of California, which they announced today, California is basically getting shut down, because of people that stayed in their rooms and prayed to God for his Holy Spirit to infiltrate their lives, to change them, I'm sitting here before you in Apostolic Church right now. I'm in one of our buildings. I get to sit and bask in their fruit because of people that got on their knees and prayed before God. People that got that one-on-one connection with God. And I'm encouraging you guys to learn more about him. Hopefully we can continue to learn about him through this historical book. I'm really excited. Hopefully you guys stay along with me. I hope each and every single one of you are able to get closer in this pandemic. And the real pandemic is that we need Christ. Each and every single one of us do. And we need him badly. Desires that God blesses you. That you're able to learn something through these videos. I don't know if you learned much now, but I'm really excited to go through this book with you because it has a lot. This next chapter is great. It's about the upper room that we had on Azusa Street. But that is it for the video. Hopefully you guys join us for the next time. I will be releasing more chapters to come as they come and go. I'm very busy-ish, okay? So I would expect them probably every other day, maybe every other day, but I'm trying my best to push these out as fast as possible. It is very time consuming, but I'm happy to do it, and hopefully we can learn something in Christ together. My desire is that God blesses you, and remember, if you're not learning, you're not growing, and if you're not growing, you're probably dead. God bless you guys.